Hey, welcome to today's Google Plus Hangout with the X Factor Season 3 contestants. I'm Lindsay Parker. You may know me from Yahoo Music's Reality Rocks column. I'm very excited to be back to moderate another Hangout. We've got some of the top four boys and top four girls. They've made it to the top 16. They're on their way to the live shows. Before that, they're going to talk to you guys. So let's introduce them. Let's start off with, from the girls, Dani Geimer.
Hey. Hi.
Hey. Next up from the boys, Josh Levi.
What's up?
Hey, good to see you. Kaya Cohen from the girls, hello.
Hey, guys.
And also from the girls, obviously, Ilona Santiago.
Hey.
And then finally from the boys, a guy who had a very dramatic moment last night on the show, Tim Olstad.
How's it going, guys?
How are you doing? Have you calmed down since that moment?
Yeah, I mean, yeah. I got some sleep last night. A little sleep last night.
It was definitely some very dramatic television, and we'll definitely be talking about that because I've got a bunch of questions, Twitter questions from your fans, really good questions. I may throw in a couple questions of my own, but we're going to start off with a question that actually, I mean, obviously we just have to start with this one. It's from Otilla Price, and she, or he, wants to know, what's the scariest part of the competition? And Tim, I have to start with you because obviously it was pretty scary what went down with you. So let's start with you. What's the scariest part of the X Factor so far?
The scariest part was definitely, you know, the best part was getting a chair, but then the scariest part was knowing that you were never safe. And like yes. Simon said, you know, you're not safe until the end. And so that was pretty scary because you feel sort of safe, but you also are like, oh man, my seat could be taken away from me at any point in time.
Yeah. So true.
What about you, Dani? You want to chime in there? Is that, do you agree, or what's been the scariest part of this
no,
so far?
No, yeah, I definitely agree. It's also like the crowd had like so much to do with it. Yeah. And when you're sitting there, you think, oh, I'm kind of like part of the audience. And when they start putting up their fingers, it's like I'm not one of you guys. That's awful. Yeah. Why are you doing it?
Yeah. For me. It was definitely like that because I was the last one, and so I felt like I was part of the audience, and I was getting comfortable, and then they were like, okay, it's time to go, and I was like, oh my gosh, this is actually real. Am I going to do this? So.
Actually, Josh, that's a good question. Is it an advantage or is it less or more scary to be the last person so you have four people sitting there and you know you've got to, you know, bump someone off, or is it worse to go first and then have to sit through that whole ordeal? What do you guys think? What's better or worse? Sorry, Josh, let's answer that.
I think being last would be better than being first, because then you don't have to get up if you get a seat, so that's my thing.
I think last was the scariest for me, and I was the last one of the girls, because, I mean, I watched all the girls, and all my energy was draining out, because I was rooting for each and every one of them, and by the time I came on the stage, my energy was, like, down, and I was like, oh, no. So it was really nerve-wracking, so I was about to throw up.
Oh, no.
That's how nervous I was.
What about anyone else? What does anyone else want to chime in on what the four-chair challenge is like, how scary it is? There's a lot that the audience sees, that screaming audience that America at home doesn't get to see.
I really liked, like, I don't know, I thought it was a good way to do it because it was really dramatic TV, but, like, and, like, watching it on TV was a lot cooler, but, like, when you were there, like, the audience was just so, like, they got really passionate about who they wanted and who they didn't.
Yeah.
And, like, me and Dani were sitting next to each other, and, like, people were, like, putting up their hands and like, the numbers. And, like I remember, like they would put up, like, in the number one, and the person in the number one chair, I would just look at them, and they'd be like, yep, I'm going home. And it's just, like, it was so sad. And I was, like, I would turn around to the audience. I'd be like, stop, these are my friends.
I'm sorry. Well, the four-chair challenge is over. Are you guys at all, let's go around the horn about, are you guys excited or scared for the live shows? Let's start with Ilona on this one. You've done the live shows before, actually, Ilona, with Intensity, but now you're
solo.
Yes, I
have.
But this time it's solo.
Yeah, this time it's a solo. I mean, I'm so excited. I'm just ready to see the stage, and I'm just ready to do my thing and just for what's to come. But it's also scary because, I mean, it's the live show, so we need to bring it on and really just give all that we've got.
Yeah.
What about you, Tim? How are you feeling? You have a couple weeks, I guess, to sort of mentally prepare, but how are you feeling about going into the live shows?
Yeah, I mean, I'm feeling really good. I think what I need to do is, like, you know, prove to Paulina and prove to America that she made the right decision to keep me in the competition, and I just have to, like, give it my all and go from there and just do my best. So.
What about you, Kai? How are you psyching yourself up for?
I'm pumped. Like, I can't wait to, like, be able to work with, like, these professionals, and, like, the routining we did last time was so much fun. Like, I love practicing the songs and, like, hearing what the track sounds like, and then being able to do it on the big stage. And, like, I've only done that twice so far, and, like, it's awesome that now I get to do it, like, weekly, and that's, like, such great motivation to want to stay on, is that, like, I can do this another week, and I love performing, so it was awesome.
And Josh, what about you?
I'm ready. I think we've definitely gone through, like, the hardest part.
I feel like
the four-chair challenge and then making it to top 40 was really hard and the scariest part for me, so I feel like this next part's about to be fun.
And how about you, Danny?
I'm so excited, but I feel like I'm the only one who's also, like, nervous. Jeez, you guys are so confident and stuff.
We're nervous.
Well, it's because, like, you have no idea what's going to happen. I feel like the night of the show is when I'm actually going to see the stage. When I have no idea when anything is going down. It's weird.
Yeah.
Well, I'm sure you guys will all do good. And we have another fan named Danny17 with many A's, D's, N's, and I's. Danny17. And she, actually, this relates to what we were just talking about. She wants to know what it's like working with your mentors so far. Have you gone to spend some time with them talking about what you're going to do with the live shows? How is it working with the judges so far? Let's start with, I'm going to just randomly side Kaya.
I mean, we haven't really gotten to work with them yet, which is why I'm so excited. Because, like, I know that, like, I think behind the scenes they've been putting in a lot of work for us. But, like, I've only met Demi, like, once, like, when she, like, peeked out behind the curtain and stuff. So I'm really looking forward to being able to work with her more.
What else are, Danny, what are you looking forward to most with getting to work with with Demi?
I think it's so exciting to be able to work with Demi because, like, I've looked up to her for so long, and also working with all these professionals who really know what they're doing, and then being able to, like, do that on stage, that's, like, an amazing experience.
And Josh, what are you most looking forward to? You will be working with Paulina, obviously.
Yes, Paulina. I'm excited to see what we can come up with. Like, she's really cool, and I want to see the ideas that we can do and different, you know, songs and everything. I'm excited overall.
And what about you, Tim? What are you most looking forward to in terms of working with her?
Yeah, I mean, I'm pumped. You know, a lot of people in America don't know much about her, but I think after I did some research and stuff like that, you know, she got her first recording contract when she was 7 years old. And so she's been in the business for a long time. And so I feel like that's just that much more that she can, you know, help us with and, you know, mentor us with. So I feel like I'm going to learn a lot from her.
And then Ilona, when you were on the show before, it was before Demi was on the show, so it's sort of, it's very much a different show now. What are you looking forward to with this new experience?
I'm just really looking forward to working with Demi because I just think that she has an incredible mind and all her ideas combining with everybody, with all the professionals would really, it's just so exciting and just to see what they can come up with and to shape an artist that we are. And I'm just so excited because Demi was in Barney, and I loved Barney. Oh, man, I'm going to get her autograph as soon as I meet her again.
That's awesome. Maybe you could do the Barney song.
Oh, yeah. Oh. That would be amazing.
Remix. Be on Barney.
So we have another question from E3 Got Swag. I imagine this person's an Emblem 3 fan. And this person has, this is a very loaded question. This is a challenging question. She wants to know, or he, what's something really crazy or random most people don't know about you? This is a good question.
Oh
Let's start with Josh on this one. I'm putting you
start
on the spot.
Start with me.
Yeah, I thought, what's something crazy or random? E3 got swag, really wants to know. Something
I'd
people don't
say
know.
I harmonize with the vacuum cleaner.
I hit it with a hair dryer.
Oh, okay, good. Okay, I feel normal.
You're not the only one.
Okay.
How does that work?
Well, it's like, it's the same note the whole time. So you just kind of do a note.
Unless you change the speed.
Yeah. Or, you, yeah.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
What about you, Kaya? Do you harmonize with cleaning appliances or anything?
I mean, I harmonize with, like, the way I learned to harmonize is, like, I would put on, like, a song and then I just, like, sing it, like, the harmonies to it. And my favorite one to do it to is, like Adele, Someone Like You. It's, like, so depressing because it's such a depressing song. And I'll just be in my room and I'll be, like, harmonizing and I'll be, like, I don't know, I get really into it.
But what's a random crazy thing people don't know about you, Kaya?
Oh, God. Let's see. Well, this isn't that crazy, but, every Monday I sing to patients in the hospital.
That's a good thing.
Yeah.
That's good. That's not crazy.
Yeah, I can't sing. A few more crazy things. I don't know.
And Danny, what about you? We all know you read books, which for some reason some people think is crazy. I don't think that's so crazy.
That's
I read
crazy.
Books too. But what's crazy or random thing that we don't know about you?
Maybe that I don't really listen to music that often. Like, I feel like everyone probably, like, their life is music. I love to sing, but, like, I don't really know a lot of music.
How did you get into music then? If Chase last week in last week's Hangout said the exact same thing, which I think is so interesting.
Really? Oh. Well, I don't know. I started when I was really young, and I just grew to love it, but I've always been, like, super busy with other things. Like, so I would sing, but I wouldn't have time to, like, listen to music. I don't know. I play softball, and I don't know. School's, like, a big part of my life, so that's it.
All right.
A little boring.
Slightly crazy. And then Alona, what's a crazy or random and or random thing about you that we don't know yet?
Well, I'm pretty shy, actually. At school, like, to talk during class, I'm really timid. Like, I'm afraid of speaking in class, but when I sing, like, at our talent shows, people just see a different side of me, and they're just like, what? That came out of you?
And, you don't seem shy to me.
I am shy. Okay. I'm comfortable now. And I guess, like, every morning, I just started doing this recently, actually. Every morning, I hold on to my bed and squeeze onto it, and just to take the tense out of me.
What?
I don't know.
Oh.
It seems to work. It seems to work.
It does.
Awesome. And then, Tim, I need to ask you this question, because when you auditioned, Demi put you on the spot and wanted to hear something crazy about you, and then she didn't like your answer, and she thought... He really put you on the spot. You've had some time to think about it now.
Yeah.
Is there something crazy or random you can confess about yourself?
Well, yeah, I know. That's. I don't think I'll ever hear the end of that. other than getting kicked out of my mom's music class. Let's just go with the random. I taught myself in, like, seventh grade sort of, like, how to yodel. And so, I don't know, it's kind of like random, I guess.
Let's
I don't
hear
know.
It.
Woo! Can you yodel?
I can, but I'm not really.
Do it.
You know, as singers, you have to, like, warm up. So, like, you know, maybe next time.
Are you going to yodel on the live shows, like cover some Jewel or
something? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Awesome. Why did you get kicked out of your mom's class, by the way?
Because I thought that her being my teacher... that I could just get away with anything. Like, I thought I could talk out of turn, I thought I could, you know, get up, walk around, you know, and obviously that wasn't the case. And so, yeah, a few times she definitely kicked me out. But yeah, I mean, that's...
she kicked you out, your own mom kicked you
my
out.
My own mother kicked me out of, she was my music teacher in elementary school, and she kicked me out because she's like, not having it, not having it.
Not having it. Classical mother.
That is some tough love right there.
Yeah.
Now, there's a... Now we have another fan named Colleen Elise. I really like this question. This is an inventive question. She wants to know who your favorite contestant was from last season of The X Factor, or your past or past seasons of The X Factor. Do any of you have a certain contestant besides we'll say Intensity, of course, because Alona was in Intensity. Mm-hmm. But who? Actually, Alona, I'll start with you, since you know you obviously have a past on the show. Do you have a favorite past X Factor contestant?
Yeah, I mean, last year, Aaron was also on it. He was actually a part of our group, and he made it top 10. So I was really rooting for him, and we communicated during his time on the show, and I even visited him, so that was really cool. And I also met, like, I think three of the girls from Fifth Harmony, Camila, Normani, and I think Dina, I'm not sure, but they were so cool. Dinah.
Yeah, they're really cool girls. What about you, Josh? Do you have a past favorite contestant?
Definitely Fifth Harmony and Janelle. I loved Janelle.
Janelle Garcia. She was cool. I liked her.
She's a hottie.
Yes.
She was definitely fiery. She was a feisty woman. What about Danny? What about you? Or I don't know. You don't if you don't listen to music much, I don't know if you watch it on TV.
No,
either,
I watched it. I did. I watched it last year. Carly Rose, she was, like, amazing. Like, I didn't even know how that voice came out of her. Like, I don't know. It was so weird, but I couldn't, like, imagine anything else coming out of her. So, it was, I don't know, it was really great. But I also love Fifth Harmony as well. They're really awesome.
Yay, Fifth Harmony.
Didn't they used to call Carly, like, the Beast or, like, the Poltergeist or You're a Wolf? Like, they were always calling her these, like, crazy names.
Yeah, they said she was possessed.
Yeah,
that's definitely the word I was looking for. Yeah.
Which was a compliment, by the way.
Yeah.
Yes.
And,
Kaya, do you have any past X Factor contestants that you liked?
It's bad that I didn't watch the show. Because I didn't really know anything about it, but one of my friends is obsessed with Carly Rose. I remember last year, like, every time I went to her house, she'd be like, oh my god, I have to show you this video of Carly Rose's last performance, and, like, she was obsessed with it, and she's really good. Like, she's so, like, natural, and, like, her voice is just so pure and, like, controlled, and she's, like, she was really young, I think, and, like, she is, like, possessed.
And what about you, Tim?
You know, yeah, I'm going to have to jump on the bandwagon and say Fifth Harmony. They, like, are unbelievable. Their harmonies are so tight, and their cover on YouTube of Ed Sheeran's Lego House, man, it's just so good.
Oh, yeah.
It's so refreshing to hear.
Very cool. So. Now, I have a question that it's my own question. But Simon Cowell last night on his Twitter, if you follow him on Twitter, which I'm sure you do, was hinting that there may be a wild card. Yeah, which is kind of interesting. So I want to know around the horn how you guys feel about that, and if there's someone that if there's anyone in particular that you're a little worried might come back because you know they'd be a threat if they came back. If you feel comfortable answering that. So let's start with Josh. Is there anyone that you think might be coming back that you're a little like, uh-oh? And how do you feel in general about the wild card, if there is a wild card?
The wild card, that's kind of scary. It's new. Everything, it's so new. I don't know. Everyone from the top 10 was absolutely amazing. I think everyone loved Al, too. So maybe, I don't know.
It was a tough category.
It was.
Yeah.
What about you, Kaya? Is there any like a person that you're keeping an eye out for that might be making a secret return?
Not so much keeping an eye out. It would more be like so excited that they came back because everyone was just so cool, and I was like so sad to see some of my friends go. So like, if someone came back, that would be awesome because I get to spend more time with them.
Very cool. That's a good answer. That's a good, like, positive answer. I'm all being negative, asking you if you're worried.
Yeah.
That's why I'm not on the show. What about, obviously, as someone who's had another chance on the show, Alona, how do you feel about the idea of a wild card?
I mean, it's an amazing idea, because I know how it feels to be booted off and to be brought back to the show. Oh man, no words can explain how it feels, because it gives you another chance to prove that you've actually got it. So, I mean, I'd go with Kai. I mean, I'd be so happy if one of our friends came back. I mean, we've made, like, a big friendship. And Yeah.
And Danny, do you feel the same way? It was a bit of a bombshell when you put that on Twitter last night.
Yeah, definitely, like, the same way. Because I wouldn't even care if there were, like, other opponents, like, or other contestants that I'm against, because we're all, like, just, we're so happy for each other, like, more than we're happy for ourselves. And, no, I was watching The X Factor last night, and I noticed that Al Calderon, he's like, he was really good, because like on stage you can't really hear it, like it's just a whole bunch of cheering and
so
stuff.
So loud.
Yeah,
and he was really good, and everyone loves him, like especially on Twitter, and so yeah, I would think that he would probably be the wild card so far.
Very interesting prediction. And then of course, Tim, I have to ask you, because in a way you sort of almost were a wild card. I had like a mini wild card moment or something like that.
Yeah,
you were like an instant wild card where like you left, you came back. So how do you feel about the idea of another person getting a chance like that?
You know what, I think it's great because I kind of got a wild card in a way as well. So I think it's great. And I think Simon said something about he wants the, you know, he wants the America to choose who they want back. So I think that's great because that gives America, a chance to say, you know, this was our favorite person who we thought should have gone through, and so, you know, let's use social media to let it be known.
Very, very good answers, everyone. Now I'm going to again put you on the spot, or I'm going to put you on the spot virtually because I didn't come up with this question, but someone named Liam's Waffle did. He or she wants to know, what's the most embarrassing thing that's happened to you? Which is an awesome question. Sorry to ask it, but I can't resist. Let's start with Danny. Do you want to answer, what's the most, not necessarily on the show, just in your life, what's the most embarrassing thing that's happened to you? You have a good story?
No, I don't have, like, any stories because, like, I'm not someone who, like, goes out very often. So, like, what's embarrassing is, like, what other people see. And, like, no one sees me. Like, I'm under my bed the whole time. So, I don't know. Can I get back to you on that one?
Yes, you can. I'll move on to Josh. Do you have, what's the most embarrassing thing that's ever happened to you?
I actually said this on my Yes, I Made It video, but I tried to fix a bad haircut, and it went the wrong way.
What happened?
Well, I was changing. I used to have a mohawk, and then I was changing it to a new haircut. And then I didn't like the back of it, and so I tried to cut it, and I, like, created a big box of no hair. So that's definitely the most embarrassing.
I once cut my baby hairs off, and it was such a bad decision.
Was that the most embarrassing thing that happened to you, Kai, or do you have a different
probably
story?
Not, because that was, like, pretty long-term. But probably, this isn't the most embarrassing thing, but it's pretty embarrassing. My freshman year, we had to do a project on Hamlet, and so I wrote a song about, like, Hamlet. I wrote one song about Hamlet, and the teacher played it in front of the class, and I just, like, left the classroom because it was embarrassing. But then I had to do another thing, like a music video on it with one of my friends, and we rapped, and I wrote, like, a whole rap just about Hamlet, and everyone saw it, and, like,
about Hamlet.
Pretty embarrassing.
That actually sounds not embarrassing, but awesome. I would actually encourage you to maybe perform that on The X Factor.
Yeah, I want to hear it.
Is that on YouTube? Is that out there on the internet?
No. There was a video, another project I had to do, where we, like, birded in Central Park, and I dressed up as, like, a, like, forest ranger or whatever, and, like, put on an Australian accent, and that was on YouTube for a while until my science teacher told me I should take that down, so.
Oh, man. Oh. I'm going to try to find it. That sounds kind of awesome.
No.
You're like, no. what about you, Alona? What embarrassing moment do you want to share?
I have a lot, but one that really stuck with me is at Universal Studios, you know that House of Terror?
Mm-hmm.
You go in with everybody. So I went in, and I'm a scaredy cat, and I was holding on to anybody I can, and I thought I was holding on to my sister. And when it came out, it was some different girl. I was like, oh my god, I'm so sorry. And I was like literally squeezing her, and my nails were like digging into her arm. I'm like, oh my god. And she looked at me and was like, who are you?
She didn't say anything when you were doing that? She just let you do that?
Yeah, because I guess she thought it was her friend or something.
That's so funny.
That is that really
is
funny.
That is definitely embarrassing.
It's embarrassing, but it's
so
pretty
bad.
Funny.
It's funny, yes.
You were scared. People will understand. What about you, Tim? Is it the fact that you got kicked out of your mom's class, or do you have a more...
No. Yeah, one thing that really pops out in my head is back in high school, it was the end of the year choir concert, and I had a solo, and I went to hit this high note, and I was like, oh, yeah, I'm going to nail this. I'm so, you know, I'm confident about it. And then I went to hit the high note, and my voice cracked like, oh my gosh. It was just like... Can I leave now?
It happens to all of us.
It's okay.
Yeah,
it happened to me, too.
It happens to the best singers out there. Now, we only have a few minutes left, so I'm going to try to squeeze in a couple questions. Cree Lands wants to know, who are your role models that you look up to? I'll start with Danny on this one. I'm going to let you go with the embarrassing question. We don't have time to come back to that. I'll let it slide. Maybe you can do it another time. Who are your role models or role model that you look up to?
Role models. Definitely Demi. I'm not, like, trying to get on her good side. I just think she's, like, an amazing person, an amazing artist and everything. Also, who else? Like, everyone's asking me who's my, like, musical influences, and I've never been asked, like, who's just, like, a inspiring person to me. Jeez. Thanks. I don't know. Yeah. I'm going to say Demi Lovato. That's it.
That's a good answer. That's a good answer. Hopefully she's watching this. What about you, Josh?
I'm going to have to say Justin Timberlake. He's amazing. I love all of his songs. Bruno Mars can sing his butt off. Those are definitely my main two.
Good role models to have, for sure. What about you, Kaya?
Probably my brother or, like, my family. Not a celebrity, but they're just like, they've helped me like grow up and stuff, so, and they did it pretty well, so, yeah.
That's a very nice answer. And Alona, let's move on to you. It can be someone musical, or it could be someone personal, or both.
I'd say Beyonce. I mean, I looked up to her since I was little, too, and I have her concerts, and I'd watch them every day, and her presence on stage is just... Oh, it's so amazing. I mean, she can sing, she can dance, she acts. She's perfect. I mean, I know nothing's perfect, but
she's perfect.
I mean, the definition of perfect
she's
is actually
perfect,
Beyonce.
And she, like all of you, started at a very young age doing this. Started as a child.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely.
That's
she's
very
one
good
of my
role
biggest role models. Yeah.
Very cool. Have you talked to Kelly Rowland about her at all?
Yeah.
I want to. I seriously want to because, I'm so excited.
Oh.
Oh, my gosh. When I hug her, I know I'm sure she's hugged Beyonce before, so if she hugged her, then that means I hugged Beyonce, too.
I like that logic. That logic works for me. And then finally, Tim, let's move on to you for your role model.
Yeah, role model. I mean, besides my family, them being so supportive. I would say musically, Ron Pope, Mark Broussard, Dave Barnes, to name a few. I mean, they are all such hardworking artists that I think need a lot of recognition because they work their butts off, and I really look up to them. So.
Very cool. Now, we've only got a couple minutes left, so we got to do this one quick, but I want to squeeze in one more question because we had so many. It's from Ola Loves 1D. I guess her role model is One Direction. It's a very open-ended question, so just answer off the top of your head. What is your favorite thing to do? Which is, that could be anything. Danny, favorite thing to
do? My favorite thing to do is read.
No, I didn't know you'd say that.
I love to read, but, like, I really like to watch movies, like, go to the movies with, like, my brother and stuff. And just watch movies and stuff.
Josh?
Movie happen.
I'm really close with my sister, so she's a rhythmic gymnast, and I love watching her. She's amazing at what she does.
Oh, that's really cool. And what about you, Kaya? Favorite thing to do?
I'm going to be super cliche and say perform.
That makes sense.
Yep.
I'm sure all of you would put that high on your list of favorite things to do.
Yes.
Alona, what about you?
Eat.
That's a good one.
Everybody loves eating.
That's a universal activity most people enjoy, yes. I agree with you totally on that one. And then, Tim, favorite thing to do?
Favorite thing to do, I would say, like around Christmas time, our family goes to Chicago, and we hang out with our extended family, and that's just, like, it's a lot of fun, and we always have a great time.
I love Christmas.
Yeah, well, if you guys stick around on the X Factor, you'll be spending your Christmas season on the X Factor. You'll be celebrating the whole. You'll be there in December and November.
Yay.
So,
yay.
Good luck to you all.
We
gotta wrap this up, but it was awesome talking to you all. Congratulations to all of you for getting to the top 16. For those of you out there watching, thanks for watching. Thanks for sending your questions. In less than a minute, the X Factor starts on the East Coast on Fox. So everybody, switch over and watch that. If you're on the West Coast, it'll be on at 8 p.m. Good luck to all you guys. Those of you who enjoyed this hangout, please come back next week at 4:30. We're doing it again with some other contestants. And what else can I say except X Factor? Woohoo!
X Factor!
Raise your X's. Yeah. Thank you, everybody, so much.
Thank you, guys.
Bye. Thank you.
Thanks.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.